Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today I can't believe I never made this video. I'm doing 6 years on my 6 year of videos now, and this is like a key super important video, and I think I've alluded to it a few times, but I've never directly made it, and I don't know why. But oops, okay, someone asked me for this, the scripting on this, so I'm gonna go ahead and make it. And you can see I don't get embarrassed at all when I talk about this. You know, it did take some practice, definitely. You have to practice talking about it, making sure you're not showing it in your face, making, if you look uncomfortable, the parents and the patient is going to be uncomfortable. So if you don't think that you can have this conversation correctly without being embarrassed, then you need to delegate this conversation to somebody on your team. Now, there are plenty of male doctors that have zero problems with this conversation, and good on you if you're not embarrassed. It doesn't have to be same sex. You don't have to have a girl patient and have a girl talk to a girl. You don't have to have a boy patient and have a boy talk to a boy. You know what I mean? It's all in who's confident and who feels comfortable. I do find boys are easier to talk to. It's not as embarrassing as the girl stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and take you through both scenarios in exactly what I say. I don't care who has the conversation, but if you are treating any patient from age 8 to 14 and it involves any type of growth modification or any type of skeletal expansion, you have to have this question and you have to talk about it. And what you don't want to do is you don't want to just rely on your medical history. That is a huge mistake, because I can tell you, as a parent of teenagers myself, this question gets on so many medical histories, and a lot of times I just skip it, check no. It's really, in my mind, I'm thinking like, this is not relevant. So a lot of patients, first of all, a lot of parents really don't know the answer to this question. So do I rely on the parents for the answer? No, I rely on the patient. And also a lot of parents are like me and they're like, it's not their business. Why do they need to know about my daughter's period? This is teeth. They don't get the connection. So they may mark no when it's really yes. You know what I mean? Because they don't understand the why. So you need to explain the why and validate it and explain the why behind the question so that you can get an honest answer. Because if you don't get the right answer here, you're going to have a treatment plan that doesn't work, most importantly, or could be dangerous or could be medically dangerous. And you know, it's just one of these, you can look up my side effects from palatal expansion lecture. If you treatment timing, you know, like how fast, how slow you do it depends so much on skeletal maturity. And also growth modification, even Invisalign with MA, it's not going to work. If your patient is no longer growing, it's not going to work. Okay. So why pick that as a, you're wasting 2 years, basically. You're wasting everyone's time. No one's going to be satisfied with the outcome because you were too embarrassed to ask the right questions at the beginning. This is part of treatment planning. Okay. Enough of the overview. We're going to get into the nitty gritty. Let's start with boys, because boys is so easy for me. I do have a girl and a boy, teenagers. So it's funny with the boy. They're both athletes, but we get these questions from coaches all the time. He does. He's completely confident. He knows why they're asking it. And he's so aware, especially athletes are very, very aware, especially male athletes, because for Division I recruiting, it's huge. You know, if you're still growing, if you're a late grower, boy athlete, it's actually a good thing. So, and do make sure you watch before you listen to this video. There's another video I want you to watch first. And I think it's called Treatment Timing, Skeletal, Chronological and Dental Age, or just look up skeletal age or dental age within Straight Smile Solutions videos. It will pop up. It probably was made 6 months to a year ago. And that's going to set, you need to understand that first before you understand this. So start there, then watch this video or listen to this video. Okay, boys. So what do I ask for boys? Well, obviously, boys coming in, boys sitting down. This chronological age means nothing to me. There are boys that are fully mature at age 12, you know, that are like not growing anymore. And, you know, my son has a friend who's, I don't know, 14, 15, younger than him, who like has a full beard already, you know? So he's done growing. I already know that. He has a full beard. I can see the full 5 o'clock shadow in the afternoon, like full beard, mustache, everything. My son has like 5 hairs on his face. So, you know, clearly the age means nothing. There are 12-year-old boys who are like fully mature and look like they're 25. And there are 12-year-old boys that are literally like 7-year-olds, you know? So with boys, it's kind of obvious. You can kind of tell. But obviously, I'm asking about shaving. Usually, I can see. I mean, if it's an 8 a.m. appointment, I may not be able to tell. But by 4 or 5 p.m., if they had a full beard, I can tell, you know, whether they're blonde or dark-haired. So, I mean, there are, okay, let's not fully rely on that, because there are some ethnicities that really don't have any facial hair. So for your normal Caucasian, of African descent, of, you know, any type of Caucasian descent, European descent, anything like that. I think most South, you know, people of Latino origins, you're going to get facial hair. A lot of Asians, some do, some don't. So, I mean, I hate to pigeonhole people, but that's the truth. I mean, my husband is Chinese and he has like five hairs on his face. He doesn't really have to shave. So, anyways, so that'd be the first thing, is that's pretty obvious. But if it's a morning appointment, you can ask. Nothing wrong with that, you know. What else? Shoe size. So not the size, but what size shoes do you wear right now? 10, 9, 11, you know. Okay, that's cool. When was the last time you went up a size in shoes? Have you been in size 10 for a year, 2 years, you know? Boys always know the answer to this. You know, that's a quick answer. I wear, and as a matter of fact, like I said, in athletic recruiting, they actually ask about that. They ask about shoe size and they ask when was the last time you went up a shoe size. We got that question a lot with recruiting. So, feet are usually very indicative. They grow along with jaws, you know? So, I don't know if that makes sense, but if someone's feet have been done growing for years and they've been a size 10 for 2 to 3 years, they're shaving, you know? Assuming they're not of a ethnicity that doesn't need to shave, they're done growing. And of course, voice change. Voice change is going to come before all of that. But that would be the very first thing. If he's squeaky or, you know, all over the place and it's squeaky or high or high and low, they are about to hit peak puberty. So they're still growing. So that's a dead giveaway. If they have a very low voice consistently the whole conversation, then I'm going to move on to the shaving and foot question. If and when, I mean, for boys, this shouldn't be a problem. This should be a slam dunk. You should be able to get your answer if they're still growing or not. Obviously, like I said, I like to see them, in my mind, they're done growing if their feet haven't changed size for the last 2 years and if they're, you know, have a fair amount of facial hair. It doesn't have to be a full beard, but it has to be a fair amount and they're actively shaving and stuff. And then, you know, obviously voice too has to have dropped as well. So all three of those things usually tells me that they're done growing. If you are not sure, you can always verify with a hand wrist x-ray. And I have a great guide to hand wrist x-rays. It is available in our store, or if you are one of our clients, we will give it to you for free. So take a look on our website. I've kind of made it a lot easier, but you can also just Google it. There are some journal articles. It's just they're so confusing. I mean, it literally took me such a long time in residency to figure it out. And then I was like, I can make this more simple, like to understand, because it's confusing even to me. But yeah, you can take a hand wrist x-ray. We actually had one on my daughter because she had hurt her finger. So they had taken one anyway. So then I think she was about 10. I was like, ooh, let me see this. And then I was like, oh, sure enough, she's hitting peak puberty, you know? So that was kind of cool for me to see. But yeah, okay, so that's boys. It's easy, right? Okay, the girl stuff's a little more embarrassing. So again, this is where you have to preface it and you have to be calm and confident. And obviously, you definitely don't, if you have open bays or if there's any other patients around, this is not a conversation you are going to have around other patients. You need to be in a consult room or someplace private. So usually I will take the patient and the mom in another room. I wouldn't straight out ask the patient directly without the mom around because it could come off kind of creepy. So you want to make sure mom gives you permission to ask the patient the question directly. Now, like I said, quite often the parents have no idea what's going on. So I don't even rely, unless they are medical doctors or something, someone that I know they know why I'm asking, I don't rely on what they have to say because 9 times out of 10, the parents are way wrong. So with the girls, you know, we're going to preface it with, it looks like our treatment plan is going to involve, you know, palatal expansion or, growth modification. Obviously, you're going to explain what that is first. You know, you have a class two bite, you have a class three bite. We need to stimulate your lower jaw to grow. We need to stimulate your upper jaw to grow. We need to expand your upper jaw. Upper jaw is in two bones. We need to make it a little bit wider. This is what a suture looks like. It's nice to have a skull there if it's you don't think that's creepy because they can see the suture or at least a picture of it. But it's super cool if you actually have a model of a maxilla or a skull. You can buy these things. It can be a plastic replica. It doesn't have to be a real skull. But and show them the suture and say, hey, this is the suture. It's in two pieces. When you are younger, it is still kind of soft and pliable, and it's not fully fused. So we can go ahead and we can stretch it. And we can widen the upper jaw. The benefit of that is airway, you know, bite fits together, blah, 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 tongue position, all, you know, all the benefits of expansion. So, you know, less likely to have crowding, more space for your teeth, So you start with that. That's the why. This is what. So I would like to do this, but there's a point where we're already too old for this. And I need to know if you're too old or not. And unfortunately, this question is not really related to your age. It's related to some more delicate questions. So I'm going to ask you some delicate questions, but I want you to understand why I'm asking it. You know, I'm hoping that this will work out, you know? And then they're like, okay, they're prepared, right? Okay. So first of all, I say, have you had your period yet? Would be the first question. That's the easiest one to ask because it's quite obvious if they've had it or not. And you'd be surprised how many times parents don't know that the daughter has had it. So, you know, and how many times the mom may say yes, but the girl may say no. And then I like to ask, have you had just one or more than one? Or, you know, when did that start? You know, oh, it started 2 years ago. It started 1 year ago. I like to say, have you had just one or you had more than one cycle? The only reason I'm asking is a lot of times patients or girls can get like initial spotting. It's not really a period, but they think it's a period. So if they've had more than one, do they come regularly? It's nice to get a little more into it because if they only had one or two and it was started supposedly 2 years ago, I don't think that's really one. So then I might defer back to the pediatrician to evaluate that and send them with a medical eval, or then I might take a hand wrist x-ray, okay? Just to verify but if they're saying 2 years ago and it comes regularly every month, okay, boom, okay. Then I know that this is a thing and I know if it's more than 2 years, she's not growing anymore. So if that kind of makes sense. If they said it's 1 year ago and it comes regularly, okay, that was a real thing. If it was 1 year ago, I only had one or two, it may not be a real thing, you know, because my treatment timing, my treatment planning depends on this. It's really important I get critical information. So if I'm getting inconsistent information, I'm going to go ahead and verify either with the pediatrician, ask for growth charts. That's what you want to ask for, growth charts. Anytime you go to the pediatrician's office from when the kid's a little kid, they make a growth chart. And they may or may not show you the growth chart. I always ask to see it because I know exactly what a growth chart is. My pediatrician initially thought it was nuts, but then I explained why. So there's a little lit curve and it starts to flatten out as, you know, initially it's like, it, you know, it's an angle. It's going up, 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 you know, height versus weight. And then it's going to go ahead and plateau out. If it's plateaued for more than 2 years, patient's done growing, right? So you can even just ask the pediatrician directly. You can ask for the copy of the growth charts. I mean, whatever. Or you can take a hand wrist x-ray. So that's pretty much it. That's all it is. It's just that question. And then clarifying the question a little bit more, that's where it gets a little bit embarrassing. And I'm going to tell you, like I said, one time out of three, it's inconsistent. You know, like someone says yes for sure. Someone says it isn't. It doesn't sound like it is. I say, well, you know, sounds a little bit inconsistent. Let's just get a little more information. I just want to verify. It's really important that we get this right so that I know how many turns to prescribe, you know, or I know if this treatment plan will even work for you. I really don't want to start a treatment plan that's not going to be effective because you're too old, you know? And, you know, unfortunately, sometimes that's just how it is. You know, we have to change paths or we won't be able to fully fix a bite without jaw surgery, or we won't be able to fix a bite without extractions, you know, so because they waited too long. And this just brings up the whole conversation of, you know, treatment timing and the why behind phase one treatment. I can't say this more often because you guys, there are 8-year-old girls who are done growing. Okay. It happens all the time. You can ask third grade teachers, fourth grade teachers. It's happening earlier and earlier, especially for girls. And they might only have two permanent teeth in. So that's why we have to do the phase one. Every single 6 to 7 year old should be screened for phase one treatment. Do get a copy of the My Phase One Smile treatment form. It is available to any of our clients for free. Sometimes we do giveaways in our newsletter. So do definitely subscribe to our newsletter. And also you can purchase it from our store online. So, all right. Thank you so much. Hopefully you didn't get embarrassed by listening to this. I certainly am not embarrassed talking about it, you know. Didn't break a sweat at all, you know, didn't stress about it. Find the right person in your office and make sure every single patient who's doing orthodontics that involves any type of growth modification or skeletal expansion is being asked this question. And if your answers are inconsistent and don't make sense, you need to verify with pediatric growth records or a hand wrist x-ray. Thank you.